Hello from Mipim 2023, where we'll be finding out what's happening in the real estate industry across Europe. Over the last year, we've seen rising interest rates and a continued war in Ukraine and continued supply chain disruption. And we're here to find out what this means for investors and developers. To start things off, I'm going to be speaking to Jack Cox, the head of industrial and logistics at CBRE Group. Hello from Mipim 2023, where I'm joined by Jack Cox, the head of industrial and logistics at CBRE. Now, we're still emerging out of the pandemic in this recovery phase after a massive shock to the economy and the way global business operates. How are you seeing things play out in the logistics space in Europe as we emerge from the pandemic?
Well, I think it gave a real boost to investment and development. And what we observed very clearly was a sharp spike in e-commerce penetration rates as a result of the pandemic. And the developer community rallied to provide space to fulfill that need. The investor community, you know, was right there with it, funding that growth opportunity. Now, as we move into more of a normalized situation, what we see is that those markets which had relatively lesser levels of e-commerce penetration remain at significantly elevated levels, and Spain, Italy, Germany would be good examples of that. So those very visible, evidenced trends continue to attract capital into the sector. They demonstrate that those returns will be sustainable over long periods of time. And it's just a smart risk management approach to align capital, time and effort to a trend that consumers are driving.
So we're speaking about a year after the invasion of Ukraine began. Last year's MIPIM was just after the invasion began. Now, 1 year on, how is this impacting industrial logistics developments and investments across Europe?
Setting to one side the immeasurable pain and suffering caused by the Russian invasion, from a logistics occupational market perspective, there have actually been a lot of unforeseen positives from this, and effectively a supply chain iron curtain has descended to the east of Poland. So there have been significant amounts of relocation, industries, operations, businesses, out of Russia, out of Belarus, further to the east. And that the logistics buildings in markets like Poland, Finland, those key markets that share borders with Ukraine, the utility of those buildings has been significantly amplified. It's the clearest indication that logistics real estate is mission critical infrastructure at a national and regional level.
Finally, supply chain disruption has somewhat dampened comparatively to last year, but there still is some persistent issues out there. How is that impacting particularly industrial developments across Europe?
I think when you look at the composition of live projects today, we've seen a marked increase, around 30% increase in the number of logistics developments that are focused around manufacturers, be those actual manufacturing facilities or the satellite logistics buildings that service those. I think that is illustrative of a drive to shorten supply chains, to mitigate the global socio-political risk by having operations centered close to the point of consumption, close to the point of manufacturing.
Mm-hmm. Well, Jack, thank you very much.
It's a pleasure.